Hi, how are you? This is Mr. Chow from EnglishTuition.org. Now, I want to do a video to consolidate the results for the secondary school students for the year 2019. Now, previously, I've done a video that consolidated all the results for the PSI students. There was a lot of excitement, and I will post the link in the video description below for those who are interested. Now, for this video, we will be focusing on the results for the secondary students that have taken the their school exams, okay, for the year 2019. Now, the very first case that I want to mention is a student who was in the Sec 1 Express class. Now, this student came to me. He's got A for his English PSLE, but his aggregates were not on par with the peers in his secondary school. That was because he was admitted to a secondary school that was better than he had expected based on his CCA. So the CCA was very important to him, and he chose a school and was admitted as a result due to the merits of his CCA. And he was quite concerned that he wasn't able to keep up with his peers because his classmates all have higher aggregates compared to him. And knowing that his English will probably be the one that the subject that he will be struggling the most, he had decided that, you know, he needed a bit of help there. Okay, and this student, he was extremely motivated. He was very hungry. He was into sports. And I had a great time teaching him, right, because of his motivation. The hunger is there, despite the fact that he came from a relatively well-off family. Okay, but he was very motivated to want to improve himself, and he always tried to challenge himself. At the end of the year, when we got back the results, we were quite pleasantly surprised that he actually managed to get an overall score of A2. He just barely met the A2 grade, and it was not a very strong A2, right? So it could very well be a B3 grade. But in either case, I personally am very happy and very proud of this student, because he really put in the effort. And I took a picture of the essay that he had written. Most of the time for when I look at his exam paper, most of the time he actually followed my teaching, okay, and then he was able to score pretty well, okay, with the exception of the essay, right? He wanted to choose something that challenged himself. So despite me giving him the advice not to choose this particular type of question, he went ahead and attempted it, and as a result, he did not score very well for only the essay part, right? But because of his strong performance in all the other sections of the paper, he still got an overall score, A2, right? So well done, a very good effort. All right, and the next case that I want to mention, actually there are two students in this case, okay, because these two students, they are in the same group, and they have been with me for, one student has been with me for 3 years, the other student has been with me for 4 years. Now let's talk about the first student first, student A. Let's call him student A. Now, student A, when I got him, he was in the middle of his primary 6 school year, okay, and will be about to take his exam in a few months' time. So I had relatively short amount of time to work with him, and eventually he missed his A. He got a B for English, and English happens to be one of his weakest subjects. Once we get to secondary school, for his lower sec 1, sec 2, it has been pretty smooth sailing. He got a B4 for the entire year for Sec 1, but when he got to Sec 2, his results really shine, right? And he got 69.9 for his year-end examination, which is the equivalent of a B3, very close, just missed the A2 by just a little bit. Obviously, everyone were very proud of him and were very pleased with the results that he had obtained. However, when he got to this year, which is Sec 3 Express 2019, his results started to regress again. I think the key reason is that he got a bit complacent and his efforts started to slacken, and he did so poorly for his mid-year that he actually failed by just a little bit for his mid-year examination, and then he was in panic mode, right? Because as you know, failing English in secondary school is no fun because the consequence can be quite severe. The moment you fail English, you either retain or you are relegated to the next stream, right? If you're Express, you go down to NA. So it was no fun. Okay, so that was kind of a wake-up call for him, because Sec 2, as you recall, he scored 69.9. So how could a student who scored like 69.9 suddenly lose all his language skills overnight and then get a borderline failure for his mid-year examination, right? So it's very hard to imagine that. Okay, and I don't think he lost his language skills. It's more of the consistency, the focus, and the effort. The skills are there, all right? But if you don't put in the consistent effort, right, just like riding a bicycle or, you know, swimming or sports, if you don't practice, if you don't keep your focus, you're bound to get rusty. Okay, and that's exactly what happened to this student, right? But fortunately, he heeded the wake-up call, and by the end of the year, he still managed to obtain an overall C5 for the entire year. So still a confident pass, okay, but it was not a good sign. So we are hoping that going into next year, he would gather himself, right, continue to focus back to get back on track for this subject. I know it's hard because upper secondary, you know, they are in a difficult age, right? But they do have to be mindful that if they stray from the teaching, right, and they don't put in consistent effort, right, this is the consequence. That's the lesson that they have to learn. Alright, and as for student B, okay, which happens to be this guy's classmate, right? They are in the same group together. He joined me in Sec 1, okay, so now he's Sec 3 Express for this year, 2019. And from Sec 1, Sec 2, Sec 3, we've never gotten really any bad news from him, but at the same time, we have not gotten any, you know, surprisingly good news from him either. Right, he just managed to coast along and get his B4 from Sec 1, Sec 2, and now Sec 3. He still managed to maintain his B4. Right, but B4 is nothing fantastic. Right, if he really wants to aim for his JC, okay, my advice to him or to anyone in a similar situation, you know, they need to find that motivation in themselves. Right, why is getting a B3 and above important to them? Right, because if you go into Sec 4, about to take your O-levels, and then you tell yourself that, you know, I actually studying is not for me, I become disinterested in my studies, well, then nobody can help you, right? Even if you engage the best tutor in the world, they would not be able to, you know, guide you towards your goals, okay? But if you manage to find the reason, right, the key reason why you want to get a good grade, B3 and above, for English, okay, and you know, for all the other subjects as well, and qualify strongly for JC if that's where you want to go, okay, or qualify strongly for the polytechnic course if that's where you want to go, right, then at least we have a good chance of helping you get the grade that you're after, right? Okay, let's move on to case 3. After case 3, we have one more case 4, and then we're done with the video. So if you're still interested, just keep watching. So case 3 is about a Sec 4 NA student. This student has been with me for 1 year plus. Okay, and the key thing about this student is that he's intelligent, and I see the potential there, and that he can do well, better academically than where he is now. Alright, but the problem is with his mindset. Right, every time we come for lessons and we start to do a little bit of goal setting and let's try, you know, to achieve this goal, he will always come back and say, you know, I cannot make it one lah. You know, even my school teachers say I cannot make it. Right, but I understand that school teachers sometimes they just make casual remarks like this, right? But they don't do it, you know, intentionally. And the reason being, because the students themselves have proven, right, that they cannot make it, right? And to avoid that disappointment, some teachers actually lower their expectations of the students, right? You can also see from another perspective, they are trying to give more support and more guidance, make the exercises easier, you know. But I think that the N-levels, you know, Cambridge is not going to make your exercise, the exercises easier just because you tell yourself that you cannot make it. They've already decided, right, this is the paper that is going to be fair to all the students in the NA stream. Then that's the paper that you have to tackle. That's the challenge that you have to learn to cope with, alright? So you can't tell yourself that, oh, I can't make it, therefore I'm not going to put in the effort, and therefore I'm not going to achieve the results that I'm after. And one of the reasons why he's having lessons with me, okay, is because from Psych 1 to Psych 3, his English result has always been, he never failed, right? But it's always been around the borderline pass, in danger of failing, danger of failing. So Psych 4, NA, he's taking his N-levels, and during the final year exam, that means his prelim, okay, he actually surprised himself by scoring 35 upon 50, okay, for his English paper 2. So he was very excited and even took a screenshot showing me the before, you know, that his mid-year exam results and his after results, his prelim results, and put it, you know, side by side comparison, right? That was his personal best, okay, because he has never achieved this grade before, right? And, you know, as I work with him, it's only towards the end of the year that he started showing signs of knowing what to do when faced with the questions. Because before that, he was always, yeah, I can't do it, I cannot make it. Then he doesn't even bother to try to go through the steps that he was taught, right? So, but towards the end, you know, because we kept pushing him, you know, kept encouraging him, he just tried it, and then kind of subconsciously, he's starting to adapt to the questions, and he's learning, and he knows what to do when faced with the question. So the prelim paper 2 results, 35.50, is a reflection, okay, of the efforts that he had gone through. So the end level results, as of making this video, is not out yet, but whatever the results may be, I wish him the best of luck, right? And the more important thing and the more important lesson to learn, I think, for him, is not just to get to attain the academic grade, right? Is to recognize the fact that, you know, we, every one of us, when we are learning something new, we always have, we doubt ourselves, right? That can we, are we able to achieve this, right? Are we able to, you know, make the leap, okay, and be able to achieve this result that I'm after, okay? But, and before achieving that result, we will be constantly, you know, questioning ourselves. Can I do it? Can I do it? Can I do it? So this student, when he got 35/50, it actually the results validated his ability to be able to achieve this good result. So I'm hoping that, you know, he can take this to heart and go into the exam with a bit more confidence, right? And then I'm hoping to hear great good news from him regarding his N-level results. Okay, and the last case that I would like to mention, and then we close off this video, it's getting a bit lengthy, 30 minutes, it's about a Psych 2 Express student. Now this student is also another long-standing student of mine. He has been with me since Primary 6, and Psych 1, Psych 2, Primary 6, PSLE, he got A for English, okay, and he is one of my better students, to be honest, okay, because he is always very attentive, he pays attention in class, and he has very good knowledge retention. He doesn't forget easily, and pretty good memory. And I think because of his own learning ability, okay, he's able to sustain his A. Okay, in Psych 1, he got A2. Okay, I actually set a goal for him to see if he can, you know, challenge himself to get A from Psych 1 to Psych 4. Alright, in my opinion, okay, as long as, you know, any student who is able to get between an A1 to B3 is considered to have achieved good proficiency in that particular subject, especially for language, alright? So for Psych 2 this year, he managed to get B3, okay, and he just missed his A2 by a little, but I'm still very proud, okay, still very happy for him. Okay, that's the thing, right? If you set your goals high, even if you missed it, it's B3, right? Not a bad grade. Okay, and he's able to, you know, go into the stream that he wants, okay, for Psych 3, Psych 4. And I'm hoping to continue to see good work from this student. Next year, he's Psych 3, Upper Psych. The questions are going to be more challenging, more difficult. It's not going to be so easy to get his A2 and B3 anymore. Alright? But the fact is that the thing I noticed about this student is that his consistency is better than most of my students. He's very consistent with his work. He comes here every week, his homework is finished. I don't have to worry about him. Alright? And then if he couldn't make it for lessons, he would just message me and ask for a makeup. Now, a lot of students, you know, if they can't make it, they will be so happy because it's an excuse not to come for lesson, right? They did not want to come for the lessons. They came for the lessons because one, either no, they are forced to, they had no choice. Okay, they're failing the subject, or two, their parents forced them to come, right? They did not want to come, right? So if we get, you know, an excuse, say, no, I have a CCA or something unexpected came up, you know, social gathering or whatever, people just say, I can't come for the lesson. And they will never ask for makeup, right? But this student, he will ask for the makeup. I don't know, maybe he's forced to as well, right? Okay, but the thing is, the effort is there, all right? So if you put in the effort, you reap the rewards, right? As simple as that. All right, so overall, for all the secondary school students that I have for 2019, okay, I think pretty satisfactory results, okay? Everybody, you know, very smooth sailing, promoted, okay, up to the next level. No one fell through the cracks. No one went from express to NA or NA to NT and that type of thing, right? And it's only a matter of whether they're hitting their personal goals or not. Some did, some did not, right? And for those who did not, hopefully they'll work harder, okay, for the year 2020. Okay, and for the two Sec 3 express students moving on to Sec 4, next year is their O levels. I'm hoping that next year will be their final push, okay? And then I know some of them may not like the subject that much, okay, but if they're going on to poly, then they never have to do English again, right? But this is the last chance for them to achieve mastery for English. And then we go out into the working world, you know, the skills are going to stay with you, the skills are going to, you know, be with you, right? Even when you're communicating with other people, writing proposals and reports and all that type of thing, right? So, yeah, that's all I have in this video. Okay, next video, maybe I'll just do one more as a reflection to close up the year for 2019. If you wish to see further video just like this one, remember to subscribe to the channel, and I will talk to you soon in the next video.